just watched a couple of videos this morning about a YouTube user called DerivedEnergy. He apparently has been arrested in Jakarta, Indonesia, in possession of marijuana, which is, you know, as anybody with half a brain cell will know, it's a pretty big deal in that part of the world. He's been living there, from what I gather now. I'm only picking all this stuff up this morning and relaying it here, because the petition I'll be coming to at the end. Yeah, he's been working there, teaching English as a foreign language, I don't know for how long. And in February, apparently, he was arrested in possession of two joints and about a gram bag of marijuana. Like a ridiculously small amount. But that's the law in that country. I disagree with it, but that's the law. Doesn't mean I have to put up with it or sit back and say, fuck him, it's his own fault, you know? I think it's a shitty situation. I think it's a ridiculous state of affairs where somebody can be put in jail. He's facing somewhere between 4 and 12 years in jail. 4 and 12 years in jail for two joints. I don't even get, you can get to smoke the fucking joints, you know? The details of the case, I have no idea, really. I'd also say that I don't have a great deal of love for this guy, DerivedEnergy. He's an antinatalist, and I'll be honest and upfront, I think he's a bit of an asshole. I had dealings with him only once before. It was somewhere around a year ago. I dipped my toe with the antinatalism pond, bottomless pit, for a day or two. This whole emendum stuff and DerivedEnergy and all, I don't know who the players are in that thing. And I had a bit of an exchange with this guy, DerivedEnergy, and it wasn't one of those ones that went swimmingly well. It was one of those antagonistic comment exchanges that happened over a day, and I thought he was such an asshole. I was compelled to post a video about it. Having said that, he's a member of the community. He's one of us, you know. Just because I don't agree with him doesn't mean I want to see him languish in an Indonesian jail for the next 12 years. So I went over to the change.org site today and I signed the petition, put my name on it, and I'd encourage anybody who feels similar to go and do the same. I'll leave links below, of course. I'll try and leave a link to one of the newspaper articles. It's very sketchy information. Something along the lines of there was a tip-off. Locals gave the police a tip-off. Now, one of the videos I watched this morning was from Greytex, and he was kind of sort of having a bit of a rant against these armchair... I'm trying to hold it down. This dog's just... You can smell the bitches. Armchair activists, and saying it was pointless, etc. And, you know, to an extent, I sort of agree, you know. I don't think a petition of 500 names from people on YouTube is going to make a massive dent. Knowing what... how the law is applied over there, they're very, very strict. I think DerivedEnergy was extremely stupid to do what he did in that country. But can I say that I wouldn't be as stupid myself if I was in the same position? If I was living over there for a year, I wouldn't be walking around rolling joints out in the main road. But you know, he was in his house, apparently. He was in his apartment, his domicile, and the police barged in, you know. It's easy to call him stupid, but would I be any less stupid? I don't know. Anyway, I've been reading about Jakarta and Indonesia, and you know, it's a massively corrupt system. The police are very corrupt. Greytex made the point that, look, it's not going to help his case if you start telling them in the petition that it's a corrupt state. But people in Jakarta are saying the exact same thing. There's demonstrations on the streets at the moment about police corruption and trying to force the president to finally, you know, show a little bit of moxie and do something about the corruption. And there was another change.org petition recently, had a local one set up by a Jakarta woman. I think it's a woman, sorry, I don't know if the name, anyway, a Jakartanese person set up a petition to try and force the president to instigate changes or to challenge the police or to set up an inquiry or something along those lines. And it was successful. 15,000 people put their signatures to that petition. And lo and behold, the president is now seemingly doing something. I wouldn't say that that's going to change the world. Something happened similar in 1998-99. I was doing a search for police corruption, and the president back in 1998-99 did the exact same thing. He set up a commission to investigate police corruption under his predecessor. I don't think the point really is how successful a piddling petition of a couple of hundred YouTube subscribers is going to make, is going to make any difference in this case. It's not the point. It's a sign of solidarity. It's like I said, it's one of us. I do the same for any of you, I think. You know, if you're a cop smuggling heroin, different stories, I know, but I smoke dope. I've smoked dope all my life, and it's not like he was caught smuggling a couple of kilos, a couple of joints. I mean, if you're a tourist, you could get the same. You could, you know, find yourself in the same situation. So, even though I don't particularly like the guy, I don't particularly respect him, I don't have any time for his views. Yes, as Greatex pointed out, he would be in favour of those kind of totalitarian regimes that kind of force people not to procreate. But just because he feels like that doesn't mean I have to just sit back and say, well, lucky you got your just desserts now. It's not even really about derived energy. But I wouldn't wish that on my worst enemy, and despite not liking him, I couldn't call him anything approaching my worst enemy. So I've rambled enough. The petition link is going to be below, and do a quick search of derived energy and Indonesia and you'll find a whole tranche of videos. Suss it out for yourself. Take care.